In a coke this afternoon, snuffed it up my nose. Gone. Brilliant. Makes your eyes water. I went away to Egypt. I'll sing it to you in the original West Midlands. I went away to Egypt to work there for a while, and I fell in love with Tara, the flower of the Nile. I had to earn some money so as her and me could wed, and I got the job as the foreman bricky down on the pyramids. Good to have a sing and a laugh and get it all out of your system. Well, the Pharaoh of old Egypt was a crummy little creep. He come out almost every day inspecting in his jeep. He had a big fat belly and a little pinted head, and everyone what said him thought he was already Jed. Did you understand that? That's great, it's great. Because normally, after we explain, everyone who saw him thought he had already expired, you know. Oh. Well, then one day it happened that the Pharaoh of Egypt, he come to see how we was getting on with his creepy crypt. He took one look at Tara, and him she did be guile. And the next thing that I know, there's both floating down the Nile. So I crept into the fair, this is the real chorus, to the Pharaoh's crypt and cried all alone. In the creepy crypt I cried and cried, lost my little Tara, tears I could not hide. I crept into the Pharaoh's crypt and cried. Coke's starting to work. Well, the rest of this sad story, it's hard for me to tell. They had a royal wedding, they rung the wedding bell. I watched until she promised to be his faithful bride. Then I crept into the Pharaoh's crypt and cried. Ooh, I crept into the Pharaoh's crypt and cried all alone. In the creepy crypt I cried. Lost my little Tara, tears I could not hide. I crept into the Pharaoh's crypt and cried. I slipped inside the sepulchre and sighed. All the tears fell on Tutankhamun's tomb. Everybody.
Sitting in the front are now going, why did we sit here?
No, they're not. They're up for it. Look, they're up for it. And they know it as well.
Bring it on.
Do you want to go back to the stage and demonstrate the action?
Hold the ribbon in your hand. Feel it start to strain.
Good, they're good, aren't they?
They are good.
Yeah.
When the ribbon breaks apart, I used sure. Should be all right. My heart will be the same. Well, my heart will... I can't remember what the words are now. When the ribbon breaks apart, my heart will do the same. That's it. I wish the ribbon in your hand was heavy, heavy chain. Now, yesterday I performed with Incy Wincy Spider crawling around in my hair while I was on stage. Anyone that saw me, I had a small spider.
Quick, my knees are going, darling.
And so I think Incy Wincy Spider, it helps. With every link, a link of love, I'd bring you back again. Aww. That's it. It's easy. You've got it. Okay, this is the ribbon.
Together.
Come on.
Fingers are crossed for a no. Right, so this song's called Steel Cranes, and what that's about, if you go through Glasgow on the M8, or likewise if you go past Tyneside or any of the old British shipbuilding towns, you'll see all the dockside cranes still there, haven't moved in decades, sort of silent testament to an era gone past. So this is called Steel Cranes. Featuring, if I'm lucky, a digipipe break in the middle. I'm standing by the river, I'm gazing out to sea. My mind rolls back the gears when my feathers stood by me and showed me all the sights of a river in its poem. I guess he never knew the end was coming soon. Great liners on the slipway, freighters at the quay, order books of women, just a memory. Korean yards and labour rates dealt to fatal blow. Empty shipyards home to the pigeon and the crow. And those steel cranes stand idle by the river that once dropped to the heartbeat of trade and industry. Steel cranes, your strong arms lifted skywards, the lifeblood of an empire and sent it on its way. Leaning on the railings of Greenock's Esplanade, there before your eyes, Britain's marching power displayed. The tankers and the cargo ships at the anchors rise, waiting on the pilot boat on the morning tide. Submarines and frigates, vessels great and small, Cunard's mighty monarchs, like Clyde has built them all. But now the strips lie empty, the ships they come no more. Engineers and skippers just passed upon the shore. And those steel cranes stand idle by the river and dance up to the heartbeat of trade and industry. Your strong arms lifted skywards, the lifeblood of an empire, and sent it on its way. The city now much cleaner, there's no sense looking back. Tenement blocks are trendy now, no longer city black. Redeveloped Auckland hides the stars of industry. Just another chapter in a city's history. I'm standing by the river, my family stands with me. There's shops and concert venues where the peace I choose to be. But I still mourn the passing of the city's burning pride. Great steel ships have sailed the world, built here on the Clyde. And those steel cranes stand idle by the river. That watch drop to the heartbeat of faith and industry. Steel cranes, your strong arms lifting skywards. Blood of an empire incepted on its way.
Special deal this year where we're going to let you have, if you buy a weekend ticket for next year, this weekend, you'll get it at this year's price. I don't know if you know that.
This year's early bird price.
This year's early bird price, which is even better. Right. As you know, that these things don't happen without the help of a lot of people. Now, you also know that we've lost Dave Johns, who organised the first festival, which is very sad. And of course, he's lumbered us with a load of work every year now. In fact, I can't believe that we'd be here after the sixth ever festival, because we thought we'd just organise one, we'd have a blast, and we'd all go home. But it's taken over our lives, hasn't it, really? Anyway. We need to thank all the people that have helped us along the way. And the biggest thing, of course, is when people are arriving on the campsite. How many of the stewards are still here? I know a lot of you have gone home. How many of the stewards are still here?
Some on here.
Oh, some there, yeah. Right, a round of applause for the stewards, of course. Now, helping the stewards on the campsite were the Kayla Band Alter Ego and the Scout Explorers. Oh, they've been run ragged all weekend. And of course, there's the Moira Furness Trust, who allow us to use this site every year. So I think thanks to them as well. And of course, there's a myriad of other people. John Lomas, who brings the bar, he brings the second marquee, he brings chairs and tables and all sorts of things. And we couldn't do it without him, so thanks for that. The Scouts, of course, who have put up, how many tents have we had this year?
Five
tents put up by the Scouts, it's great. And of course, one has been demolished this weekend, of course, you probably noticed that. We managed to lose one last year, didn't we, on the Sunday afternoon, just the same. It was wonderful, it was. try and go down the field now. Who else have we got? We've got Dragonhead, who's been running the bar stage. We've got.
We've got done the sound.
Yeah, and didn't provide the sound as well, of course. We've got Eddie Daly, who did the sound in the second marquee. We've got Lux in this one as well, of course. Who else we've got?
Jeremy,
of course.
Yay!
The funny thing, Jeremy doesn't work for them anymore, but he comes back every year and has his holiday in order to do with it, so it's just wonderful. So, anyway, thanks to Jeremy. Special thanks to Graham, who took a lady to hospital, who managed to twist her leg. All things above the call of duty as well, of course. So. We're not paying you, of course. But, oh, what else is there? No, there's no free tickets, I'm sorry about this. Anyway, we need to move on because we've got to close the show fairly early because we've got to set up for the next performance. How many of you actually are stopping for a day's work? Excellent, excellent.
She says in the bar, buys a drink.
But, if any of you are, of course, we're not letting you go home. Or something. Anyway, I'll. We'll hand you back to our MC for the night, Mr. Don.
Thanks to you lot for coming.
Your festival team.
Just one thing. Have you all filled in your feedback forms, of course? Because if there's anybody on the committee you don't like, this is your opportunity to get rid of them.
I'm sure there's no one on the committee you don't like. They're all wonderful people, aren't they? Give another big cheer. Okay, so where were we? I seem to think you were all shouting for more from Something Nasty in the Woodshed, weren't you? Well, they've run on.